Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your fighter as he approaches the cage, Joe Ellias!
And that's boxing, and it's life as well. It's not about how many times you get put down or how many times you lose or win. It's about how you can come back and keep getting back up and keep moving forward. Like Rocky said, nothing's ever going to be easy. If you want something that's very hard to get, you've got to sacrifice and dedicate and keep pushing no matter what, and never let anybody tell you you can't, because tonight again I show that it's very possible to achieve anything you ever want as long as you believe it.
You ever lost it all and had to get it all back? It's got me looking back and everything was all mad. You gotta know the roads and know when to fall back. This time I want it all and it ain't all chat, but I'm mad. My mommy took my chain and went and pawned that. Life's like a movie, I record that. Dad was in jail, so I grew up calling poor dad. Sitting in my cell with a poor mag. I'm on the phone, screws peeping through the flat. Screaming like Sabrina for some Manbury, a cat. Scratch, scratch, we adapt. Point ones for a burn pack. Shit, I was comfy on the wing, you probably heard that. Cause when you come from the road, you always learn that. And even if I could, I wouldn't turn back. Cause everything was meant to be. I do 99 years for my nigga DZD. Kick back, write a book, a direct a DVD. Like, this ain't no DVD. This the realest that you ever seen, and I'm a clever breed. Shit, I can't believe we had to bury D. I'll be on the block, go shop, pop a cherry B. I was reminiscing, sipping Hennessy. More than some memories, the energies will never leave. My nigga BG, SG, he be selling weed. Then could a dank put me on my feet. Slaps on repeat, now I'm trying to stay free. Play a beat, said they want me spraying heat. Back up in jail on repeat. Porridge oats and shredded wheat. Nights out of town, trips every week.
It's not a loss if it's a lesson. You're living life, then that's a blessing. Show her love, she holds your weapon. Shining anywhere I step in. I get the white, then get to pressing. From Forest Bank to Hindley, from Hindley I went to Preston.
And please welcome your next fighter as he approaches the cage, Zanyar Kamaran!
Just don't listen. Why must you be hard-headed? I tried to explain, but you didn't hear me though. Now, I must let you. I must. But I want to. I have to.
1-2, 1-2, come through, run through. Gun who? Oh, you don't know what the gun do? Real quiet, let me think you wanna try it. Fuck around and start a riot. Niggas gon' ride, regardless, because I'm the hardest rap artist and I'm a star. Shit up for real, get up and feel. I work, I make curves, spit up and squirt. That's all I've been hearing lately. Niggas hate me when I duct tape me and make me. Put their brains on the wall when I brawl. Too late for that 911 call. Niggas stay beefing, but a lot of them bluff. But not me, cause I'm a nigga that can get out of them cuffs. You think a lot of them's tough, that's just a front. When I hit them niggas like, what you want? The battle turns into a hunt. Hit the dog right behind niggas, chasing them down. We all knew that you was pussy, but I'm chasing it now. And never give a dog blood, cause all blood will have a dog bite. Blood, fighting whatever, all up in your gut. Give it to them raw like that. And ain't no love, I do them all like that. Fall right up in their back, clack, clack. Close your eyes, baby, it's over, forget it. Never in front of your building, but nobody knows who did it.
Why? Where my dogs at? 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 Where my
dogs at? Niggas is pussies, keep you running from the werewolf. Howling at the moon on the roof. No! Get 'em. 10 niggas on 'em. Hope God's with 'em. Give me the bat, let me split 'em. I have 'em with a pillow in the casket won't fit 'em.
Ladies and gentlemen, your fighter, who will be fighting out of the blue corner with a record of 2-1 from AVT in Leeds, Joe! fighting out of the red corner with a record of 2-1 from Middlesbrough's Fight Academy. Please welcome Zanyar Kamaran.
Here we go, fight number 13. Zanyar Kamaran in the red corner, taking on Joe Ellias in the blue in this amateur lightweight contest here at BFC. I'm delighted to be joined once again by Cage Warriors featherweight Bailey Gilbert, as Harry Hardwick is cornering and in the corner of Kamaran. Bailey, we should be in for a good fight here.
Yeah, two well-established gyms here trading off.
Those two gyms, of course, being Middlesbrough Fight Academy for Kamaran and AVT Leeds for Ellias.
Straight into it with a lot of fast pace off the bat. It'll be interesting to see where this fight goes.
Both men with identical records, 2 wins, 1 loss. Nice head kick attempt there from Zanyar. The Kamaran's got a lot of support here tonight as well, which, I mean, it sort of equally adds pressure, but equally makes you want to perform even better, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, it's 100%. When you've got your crowd behind you, it's a great feeling. Nice, steady pace. You can tell these guys have got experience. They're keeping the distance and they're working the shots. They're trying to pick the shots. Lovely straight there from Kamaran.
The movement in and out is really nice of both men as well. I'm really impressed with just how many feints they've thrown. Look, they're only 3 fights in their amateur career, but just trying to get a read on the other opponent. Nice.
Yeah, both these guys, you can see there's a lot more feints as you move up the ranks. You've got to use them feints. You can't just throw shots and hope for the best.
It also uses a hell of a lot of energy, though, that you don't think about throwing in feints, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's mentally taxing more than anything. When you watch Israel Adesanya fight, that's how he drains people. He constantly feints all the time. Lovely catch of the kick there from Ellias. Nice break off from Kamaran.
Of course, Kamaran had 2 opponents scheduled before this one, but both had to withdraw due to injury. So massive credit to Joe Ellias for stepping up.
Yeah, that's the thing. When you stay ready at all times, you get to take opportunities like this and the chance to set the show on the home crowd.
Nice kick to the body there from Kamaran, but Ellias firing back with the right hand over the top.
Ellias starting to walk forward.
Both men almost seem to be waiting for the other one to throw so that they can throw a counter.
It's a very even match so far. They're very similarly built as well.
40 seconds left here in this opening round, and I'm very glad I'm not a judge for this one. Nice.
Lovely shot. Over the top hook there.
Ellias signalling maybe there, which to the back of the head, but that sort of shot can't be helped if he's like lunged in and the shot's been thrown already. Certainly wasn't intentionally thrown in the back of the head. Big right hand from Ellias.
Trading leather as we go on at the end of the round here.
Tags Kamaran in the left there as well. Kamaran firing back one of his own though. Lovely head movement from the Middlesbrough Fight Academy man. And a very enthralling opening first round there. A little bit of a stare down after. But yeah, Bailey, what did you make of that?
It's a very 50-50 round. Both traded strikes, both landed some good shots there. I'm surprised not to see any grappling exchanges at all, but they both landed some clean shots, both defended, moved out of the way of some shots as well. Both had control time in the centre of the cage. Very, very close round. How would you score that round, Jake?
I'm glad I'm not a judge, really. That's all I'll say on that one. But yeah, it's such a difficult round to judge that. How does that then change your cornering advice if you do go there and you're not sure whether you're one round up or you've dropped that round?
When you know your fighter, you know what you've seen from them there, you know where they need to work it. So when you know your guy, you can encourage them to go take it more with their ways. But if you feel like they were winning the exchanges, you just tell them up the pressure. If you feel like they've got a more of an advantage, if the round's been close on the feet and you think they're a better grappler, you tell them to take it to the ground.
Interesting to watch a little mini battle within this fight is the fight for that lead hand position. They both seem to be jostling for that.
Yeah, you can tell as you move through the card the level has increased. These guys, there's a lot of little things that they're doing to try and gain that little advantage.
movement straight back to where it was. Quick, fast movement from both men. I think that was maybe a little bit low, but
had a lovely body kick there.
Then dipped into maybe go look for a takedown, innate kick of his own. You can see the welt there already.
He shot under the single leg there. Needs to do something with it. The longer he waits there with a leg, the more chance he's got of giving Ellias time to defend it.
Ellias, though, not stressed, keeping a nice, calm, collected head to try and work his way out of this.
He's got his hands clasped. Now it's going to be a fight of strength between the jack and the leg, hands around the hips. Lovely lift there.
Ellias doing it. There we go. Cameron eventually gets the takedown. And this is maybe exactly what he needed. Looked to be mixing it up. It was very strike dominant in that first round. That first sort of takedown attempt. And he's got this right up against the cage and where he wants it.
Ellias back to the feet there. Cameron needs to do something with this. The longer he stays there, the longer he's giving them chance to figure out a way out of it.
The attack, of course, is Tyron. But just how Tyron's defending the takedown like this.
Defending takes it out of you, especially when you keep getting brought back down to the mat like that. Like I said earlier in the night, I'd rather be tired on top than tired on bottom.
Ellias now looking to try and build himself back up to his feet.
Great control of the hips there from Kamaran.
Kamaran doing a great job here though.
Lovely head pressure, keeping them pinned.
That head pressure, what does that sort of add to it? Obviously you can't use your head, but
it's just
you can
uncomfortable. It makes it uncomfortable for people, and it makes people work more drastically to go, but it also presents more opportunities when they're trying to scramble to take that pressure off the neck.
So in this sort of position then, what does Ellias need to be looking to do?
He's just trying to get his knee across the belly there to try and frame away. He's doing the right things. Just when Kamaran's on the hip the way he is, it makes it hard to get your hips back against the cage and climb up. He's about to shrug him backwards and drop him again.
And look, this has been relentless, just this constant pressure from Kamaran.
Yeah, he's got heavy wrestling.
30 seconds left here of this second round. What would you like to see from Kamaran here to maybe advance his position a little bit more?
He needs to clear that knee. He needs to push that knee down and start throwing some ground and pound. He's in a good position here, and there's only 15 seconds left, so he can start teeing off in the position he's in.
A much more dominant round for the Middlesbrough Fight Academy man. What's it like as well for you? I know, obviously, we mentioned there at the start of this fight that this is his third opponent he's had for this day. What's it like when you have a couple of opponents maybe pull out on you and you end up with somebody totally different?
At amateur level, you've got to be prepared for a lot of fights, and I think like this early on in your career, you focus more on your game plan and like your style than you do your opponent. The opponent could be anyone, so I don't think it's a massive change. And also, he's got the security of having a full fight camp behind him. But also, for someone to take the fight as short notice as Ellias has, he must have been in the gym and he must have been training. So it's all experience.
Yeah, look, you can see there, just stand there, Ellias is in fantastic shape. And how important is that then, I guess, to, especially when you're an amateur, to be ready whenever so you can step in and take the opportunities like this?
Yeah, like I said earlier, an amateur, it's all about experience, time on the mats and getting in there. So being ready at all times, you can get these fights and you can come to fight someone on the home show in front of the home crowd and the chance to upset them. And these are opportunities, and being ready allows you to take fights like this.
Like we say, that first round was very, very close, but you've got to feel like the judges have probably swayed that second one to Kamaran.
Oh, 100%.
But it could still be all to play for here in this third and final round at British Fighting Championships.
Now, Ellias straight in for the grappling exchange, is pushing him back to the cage, but Kamaran turns him back and starts walking backwards. Lovely lateral drop there.
Very nice work from the AVT Leeds man.
Lovely trip.
Now he's on the back, nice position to be in.
Very interesting change of pace going into the third round here.
Like we've mentioned,
trying to climb up for the back, try and take the back stand, and it's not very often you see that.
Like we've mentioned as well though, so many times tonight, you've got 3 minutes to do this work. So do you think that's where this change in pace has come from?
Yeah, if your corner telling you that you may be down two rounds, you've got to go out and you've got to win the fight. you've got to either get a sub or a finish, and you don't have time to mess around with them 3 minutes.
A big pop from the crowd here as Kamaran ends up. Ellias got a butterfly hook in there.
Yeah, as you can see, Cameron's pushing his hips down there. Now he's lost it, but he's back straight on the ankle to keep his man down. As you can see, he's back to controlling the hips straight away, and that's why he's able to just hold his man against the cage. And then he's going to bump him off again and try and lift.
Oh, he's doing a good job here, though, trying to defend this.
Yeah, that wizard's saving him.
Crazy to see the damage at that one kick to the body done in that first round as well. You can see the running on Ellias' body. Now right in front of his corner is Kamaran, Abdul Muhammad, George Hardwick, Harry Hardwick there. These guys are all great on the floor as well.
Yeah, MFA have got a great wrestling pedigree, so as you can see from the lads who fought earlier in the night.
Again, so difficult from this sort of position for Ellias to try and get out, pinned up, awkward positioning next to the cage as well.
Yeah, like I said, the cage adds a lot of problems. Sometimes it can be used as an advantage to climb up, sometimes it can be used by your opponent to keep you pinned, like Kamaran is doing now.
43 seconds left. Yeah, the referee asking for some more action. Oya will look to stand this back to its feet. Kamran's working very systematically here, isn't he?
Yeah, it's all slight little movements to walk his man back. He's not exerting loads of energy to get the pin. He's in a good position now to start teeing off and end the round in a dominant fashion.
It's exactly what you want to do. It'll be the last thing that the judges see. First thing they'll remember when they're coming right down.
Even in half guard where he is now, it's a great position for ground and pound. And the opponent from the bottom just doesn't have as many subs options as they do when they're in full guard.
Yeah, we've got 5 seconds left here in this lightweight contest. And we will go to the judges' scorecards. And judging by the crowd reaction here, I think that might be going to home to the Middlesbrough Fight Academy and Zanyar Kamaran. Thoughts?
It was a great fight from both guys. Ellias taking the fight on short notice. Got to hold his head high. It was a good performance from the first round. Very technical, very back and forth. Got a few good grappling exchanges in there. It was a very good fight for both guys.
Lovely show of respect between the two as well. So the scorecards are being collected in now, and we'll throw it to JJ for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of action, your judges at ringside have scored this contest unanimously in favor of your winner. In the red corner, Zanyar Kamaran. We'll be right back.